When I started growing oats, when I first started farming, my grandfather was still alive, and we were using broadcast seeders at that time. And Grandpa always said he wanted 7 oat kernels per handprint. So he'd come out, we'd set the seeder, and then Grandpa would come out and put his hand down and count the kernels. And if we had 7, we could keep going. If we didn't, we'd open the seeder up a little.
David Weisberger, who's a graduate student at Iowa State University, talked with dozens of small grains growers around the state of Iowa over the last couple years. And seeding rate was one thing his research has highlighted as an area of potential improvement for farmers.
One of the main questions that we asked was over, you know, just one slide. I had this slide that said, okay, what's your population for corn planting? And then farmers would raise their hands and they'd chime in and say, you know, anywhere from 30 to 35,000. And then I asked the second question, which is, what's your population for soybeans? And again, farmers would raise their hands and they'd chime in. It'd be anywhere from, let's say, 175 to 225 or 250 plants per acre. So then we asked a third question, which they weren't expecting, is what's your population for a small grain? And besides one farmer out of the 41, no one was really aware or thought about seeding small grains from a population perspective.
For a beginner, I guess the first thing is planting rate. And there's a lot of old stories about so many oats in a horseshoe, but it works out to about 30 seeds per square foot, or about, I think it's 1.3 million, you have to do the math, 1.3 million seeds per acre. And I think that's the key thing to figure out how to set your drill to as close to that 1.3 million as you can.
While the Wilsons have moved more towards grain drill calibration to get a more precise seeding rate, even the number of oats per handprint that Dan's grandpa used was probably more accurate than thinking about seeding rates in pounds per acre, because it forced you to think about seeds instead of pounds per acre. It more or less forced you to calibrate the planting equipment, in that case a seeder, but now a drill. And David says that helps you make decisions more reliably.
So over the last 2 summers, we've been able to do a couple or 3 different experiments to look at management effects on oat grain yield and oat quality. And there's some other things we'll look at in a second as well. So the first of those trials involved working in 2015 with farmers Doug Allard and Aaron Lehman, and then in the summer of 2016 with Orchard Dial. So what we had them do was a little different than the average 2-treatment trial that most PFI farmers are used to. It's not that different though. So what we looked at was 3 different treatments, right? And what those treatments were 3 different oat plant populations, all right? 22, 29, and 36 plants per square foot. So what this means is that the 3 of those farmers calculated the seeds per pound of their oat variety. So they figured out how many seeds were actually in a given pound, right? And then we sent them a really simple little equation, and they calibrated their drills so that the output on that drill would hopefully seed 22, 29, or 36 plants per square foot. All right, so it was the population-based approach that we were talking about a little bit earlier. And what we found at the end of the season was that there was no significant difference between or among any of these 3 treatments. What did differ, however, was the seed costs. So what we found is that for much more expensive, you could have the same yield, or the other way of saying that is you could get the same yield with much less seed input. Okay, so the same yield, the same test weight. The other thing that we thought was really important to examine was, would a low population have any effect on forage establishment or weed suppression? And we found that there was also no significant difference between or among the 3 treatments on legume or forage establishment and weed suppression. All right, so this was a pretty positive study where we found that you could decrease seed costs and maintain yield and test weight while still being able to suppress weeds and establish a legume or a forage. So that was pretty positive.
We have started trying to count our seed, which isn't typically done with small grains. It's typically done by bushels or pounds. But we do have size differences in small grains, and we're trying to count seeds so we know exactly how many seeds we're putting per acre. But in general, this is three bushels or so.